Hi there. In this video, we're going to take a look at Kirchhoff's voltage law and explain exactly what it means and why it can be so useful. So we've got a circuit over here. We've got a 12 volt supply, and we've got three resistors in series, a 10 ohm resistor, a 20 ohm resistor, and a 30 ohm resistor. And we've noted that the current through the circuit is 0.2 amps, and that the voltage drop across resistor R1, the 10 ohm resistor, is 2 volts. The voltage drop across the 20 ohm resistor, R2, is 4 volts, as we would expect, because its resistance is double the 10 ohm resistance, so its voltage drop is also going to be double. Remember, the resistance values are in the same ratio as the voltage drops. And we've got R3 here, the 30 ohm resistor, which has a voltage drop across it of 6 volts. Once again, that's what we expect. This resistor is 3 times bigger than this resistor, so its voltage drop, 6 volts, is going to be 3 times bigger than this voltage drop, 2 volts over there. But let's take a look at Kirchhoff's voltage law, often abbreviated to just KVL. Now, the mathematical statement of Kirchhoff's voltage law looks like this. This symbol over here, this is a Greek letter, and we use this Greek letter to mean the sum. So it could be any sum. It could be a sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus etc. In other words, the sum of all the natural numbers, or the sum of the first 20 natural numbers, as another example. But what this is saying is that the sum of all the voltages in a closed loop circuit is equal to zero. Well, does that make sense? Yes, it does make sense, and you will see why in a moment. The sum of all the voltages in a closed loop circuit, like this, this is a closed loop circuit, is equal to zero. Well, let's have a look at how that works. So this voltage here given by the battery, we can think of that as a positive voltage. Energy is going in. We are putting energy into the system. There's a chemical reaction that's happening, and we're taking energy out of the chemical bonds and we're making it into electrical energy. So we can consider this as a positive voltage. We're putting energy in. But as the current flows through this resistor, the circuit is losing energy. It's dissipating energy. There's no creation of energy here. There's energy loss. And so we can consider this a negative voltage. So that would be a negative voltage. The same thing is happening here. This is a voltage drop. We're losing voltage. Okay, so this is a voltage gain. We're gaining voltage. This is a voltage drop. We're losing voltage. Here we've got another voltage drop. We're losing some more voltage. So we can consider this as another negative value, that one over there. And across this resistor, we've got another voltage drop. We're losing energy. So this is another negative value over there. Okay, so this is a voltage gain. It's a plus. This is a voltage drop. This is another voltage drop. This is another voltage drop. Now, what does this all equal? Well, let's have a look. 12 volts plus negative 2 volts is the same as 12 minus 2 volts. Plus minus 4 volts is minus another 4 volts. Plus minus 6 volts is minus another 6 volts. Well, what is the sum of that? That's right, the sum of that is 0. So, the sum of all of the voltages inside this closed loop circuit is in fact equal to zero. It does equal zero. But we do need to make a distinction between voltage sources or voltage gains, as in the case of the battery here, and voltage drops. In other words, where energy is lost in the system. So there's a voltage drop over there, there's another voltage drop over there, there's another voltage drop over there. We can think of it another way. The voltage over between there and there gets bigger. So we go from 0 volts to 12 volts. The voltage over there to over there gets smaller. We go from 12 volts, and if we lose 2 volts, if this starts out at 12 volts, it ends up at the end of the resistor as 10 volts. we've lost voltage. It's a voltage drop. There's another voltage drop from there to there. This voltage over here is higher than this voltage. This voltage here is 10 volts. It loses 4 volts. It drops 4 volts, so it comes out the other side as 6 volts. And this voltage over here is at a higher, this voltage over here is higher than this voltage over here. It comes in as 6 volts, and there's a voltage drop of 6 volts, so at the other end it is 0 volts. That is why the voltage over here, the other end of the battery, is also 0 volts. The battery does its work again. It pushes the voltage back up to 12 volts, and the cycle begins again. So we can consider this as that the total voltage rises. In other words, what's happening here in the battery, that's a voltage rise, a voltage gain, is equal to the total voltage drops. So this 12 volt gain is equal to this 2 volt plus 4 volt plus 6 volt drop. So we can see that the 12 volts given into the circuit by the battery is equal to the voltage drops across the first resistor. So this is across R1, across the second resistor, R2, and across the third resistor, R3. The voltage being put into the circuit is equal to the voltage drops across the other components in that circuit. 12 is equal to 2 volts plus 4 volts plus 6 volts. And we can have another way of saying this, and this is the expression of Kirchhoff's voltage law that you're most often going to see for a series circuit. That the total voltage, in other words, the voltage of the source, is equal to the voltage drops across all of the resistors in series, no matter how many resistors there are. If there were 100 resistors, well, the voltage drop across each of those resistors would altogether equal whatever the voltage being put into the circuit was. Now, obviously, if V1 plus V2 plus V3 were individual resistors in the circuit, this voltage total might also be the result of two batteries. Okay, so if we had two 12 volt batteries, then the total voltage gain would be 24 volts. Oops. Would be 24 volts. So this voltage total doesn't only have to be a single battery or a single source. It could be multiple sources interspersed throughout the circuit. So for example, we could, if we wanted to, insert another voltage source over there. Let's say it was gave another 6 volts. The total voltage in the circuit, the total voltage gain, would now be 18 volts, and so the voltage drops across these resistors would all change, so that this voltage drop plus this voltage drop plus this voltage drop was equal to this voltage gain plus this voltage gain over there. Now, I just want to take a moment in this video just to explain how you could calculate what these exact voltage drops are. How come this is 2 volts? How come this is 4 volts? How come this is 6 volts? Let's take a look together. So if we have a circuit, let's again say we've got 12 volts coming in, and we've got a 10 ohm resistor, a 20 ohm resistor, and a 30 ohm resistor. We know that the voltage drops across each of these resistors are in the same proportion as their resistance values. Now, what's the ratio of these three resistors? Well, we can write it as 10 to 20 to 30, or we can simplify this just to 1 to 2 to 3. So if we let the voltage drop across the smallest resistor here with the ratio value of 1 be x. Okay, so if we let the voltage drop across the 10 ohm resistor be x, well, then we can set up an equation. So we know that the total voltage given into the circuit, the voltage gain, is 12 volts, and that is going to be equal to, well, the voltage drop across the 10 ohm resistor, which is x, plus the voltage drop across the 20 ohm resistor. Well, we know that the voltage drop across the 20 ohm resistor is not x. It's going to be twice the voltage drop across this resistor because it's given by this ratio, 1 to 2. So this would be a voltage drop of 2x. Whatever x is, this is going to have double the voltage drop. And the voltage drop across the 30 ohm resistor, well, it's not going to be x, it's not going to be 2x. Its ratio with the 10 ohm resistor is 1 to 3. So whatever this voltage drop is, this voltage drop is going to be 3 times bigger. So it's going to be 3x. Well, now we've got a very simple linear equation that we can solve. 12 volts is equal to x plus 2x plus 3x, well, that is 6x. So therefore, x is going to be 12 divided by 6. Well, that's 2 volts. So the voltage drop across the 10 ohm resistor is x, in other words, 2 volts. The voltage drop across the 20 ohm resistor is 2x, in other words, 2 times. Let's undo that. Oh, goodness. Sorry. This would be 4 volts. Scratch it out. 4 volts. And the voltage drop across the 30 ohm resistor will be 3x. So 3 times 2 volts, 6 volts. And that's just a neat way that you can use if you ever wanted to work out what the actual voltage drops are. All that you need to know is what the total voltage gain in the circuit is, and you need to know the ratio of the resistors in series. What is their ratio? Now, this ratio may not be a nice ratio of 1 to 2 to 3. It might be an awful ratio of, say, 4 to 7 to 13. Okay? So in that case, well, you can still make the value, the unknown value x, but in that case, let's say we had it to a voltage gain of 12 volts again, it would not be just x plus 2x plus 3x, it would be 4x plus 7x plus 13x. So 12 volts would be equal to, well, 7 plus 13 is 20, plus 4 is 24x. Well, therefore, x is going to be equal to 0.5 volts. So the voltage drop across this first resistor would be 4 times that. Well, that's 2 volts. That just happens to be the same. The voltage drop across the second one would be 7 times that. Well, that'd be 3.5 volts. And the voltage drop across the third one will be 13 times that. So that would be 6.5 volts. And if you add those up, 3 and 6 is 9, plus the 2 halves is 10, plus the 2 is 12. You get back to the same answer. The voltage drops across the resistors are different because their resistances are in a different ratio, but we can use exactly the same way to find the voltage drops across each of these resistors, so long as we know what the ratio of their various resistance values are.